So wrong way driving is when someone enters a freeway facility going the wrong way. When the crashes occur, they tend to be really severe. So there's severe injuries and most of the time fatalities. So while they're a small segment of the crash population, because they're so severe, they get a lot of media attention, and a lot of people then want something done to combat that problem. Typically, the first thing that's done is agencies will put up do not enter signs, wrong way signs, and they also a lot of times put wrong way arrows on the pavement. If those traditional countermeasures don't work, then they may go to some innovative countermeasures, some of which have LEDs in the sign and different things that they may add to that ramp. We had a project to look at some of these innovative countermeasures and also just to step back and get some basics on wrong way driving, its characteristics, and just how we're placing traditional signs and how that might need to differ with respect to wrong way drivers. Here at our closed course on a Texas A&M Riverside campus, we were able to have subjects come in. We gave them alcohol. They got as high as 0.12 BAC level, and at multiple points we had them drive on a test track. What they did initially was there was a portion of the test track where they just drove so that we could just see the difference between how a sober to various levels of BAC people drive. Where they look was of interest to us because that helps us know where to put countermeasures.
One of the ideas is they get tunnel vision, and in particular there's a suggestion they start looking down on the road. So one of the thoughts we had there was if we, you know, could we look at a change in eye tracking patterns. And so what we were doing was watching to see that at different intoxication levels did it impact how their look patterns were. If anyone's ever seen like a shotgun blast or something like that, you have a shotgun blast and it's relatively big, this is kind of your look pattern over the road, and let's say you're not intoxicated. As you become intoxicated, the tunnel vision would be that all of a sudden they're, you know, instead of this area, they're now looking in something like this. And what we saw was that not only this, but it was also kind of more of a downward trend.
What we saw is as we get into higher level intoxications with our wrong way drivers, is they probably won't react to those engineering countermeasures. So we still need to be able to identify and mitigate those individuals that get on the system. So we need to look at detection. Detection will allow us to know sooner that we have someone going the wrong way on the system so we can react. And in addition, we can start looking toward connected vehicle technologies. This will allow us to get information from the vehicles and the infrastructure and have that detection and that quicker notification. This also allows us to get that information back to TxDOT or a traffic management center and law enforcement sooner so they can react.